You know that feeling? When you're enjoying the sunset after just having built your brand new house, when suddenly... Great, now that I have your attention, let's talk about Minecraft's way of life. Ah yes, mining, crafting, and all of the other simplicities of Minecraft to enjoy. But have you ever felt there was something missing? I can't be the only one who's been in the middle of a project and suddenly had an epiphany for a new idea. You know, the typical, wow, this feature should really be in the game. Well, my friends, get ready, because today I've put together a list of 13 useful ideas to make your time playing Minecraft even better. My name is System Z, and without further ado, let's start crafting. Minecraft Dungeons recently launched its first DLC, called Jungle Awakens. To celebrate, I'm doing a giveaway for a free copy of the game. All you need to do is make sure you are following my Twitter and give the tweet linked in the description below a good old-fashioned retweet. Make sure to keep up with my Twitter for when a winner is chosen. I'll announce it on there. Good luck! Hello and welcome everyone to 13 useful ideas for Minecraft. There is somebody behind me. As you can see, we are in a brand new workspace. This is my official workshop, a place for us to check out all of the cool ideas that you see on this channel. Guest starring Phil and Vil. Bonus points to anybody who can let me know who they are in the comments below. But these are going to be our helpers as we take a look at new ideas in the future. But today, like I said, we are checking out 13 useful ideas in Minecraft. These are different improvements to the general way of life in Minecraft. I'm sure everybody has had an epiphany of a cool idea to make Minecraft even better. And today we're checking out these 13 ideas. So, if they look interesting, stay tuned. And without further ado, let's head out. Idea number one, watering cans. Now, hear me out. I know this seems like a little bit of a stretch, but have you ever been in a situation where you needed multiple water buckets and your inventory was just too messy in order to really do anything about it? Well, the watering can would be essentially an upgrade to the bucket, allowing you to hold multiple sources of water at a time, as you can see here. So, like I said, this would allow you to essentially place water normally. Unfortunately, in this example, it's only really going to let us do it once there, but you can imagine that this could store up to 3 to 5 different sources of water, perhaps even being able to be enchanted to hold more. I think this would be awesome. Not to mention, perhaps it would also allow us to use farmable land and water it throughout time instead of having to have a water source near it. That would be awesome, and the builder in me really wants this just for the decoration. I mean, look at this thing. This looks awesome. But of course, let me know what you think of watering cans down in the comments below. Have you ever been in this situation? You've been in the woodland forest, in the woodland mansion, and you've got a long line of pillagers that you have to book in and give them their crossbows. I mean, look at this. I've got a lot of work to do. And unfortunately, bookkeeping can be quite tedious. I mean, imagine having a whole bunch of chests everywhere and having to go through them. How about instead we give bookshelves storage? This would be an incredibly useful tool in Minecraft that would allow us to organize our storage all the more better. As you can see, this is an open bookshelf and it actually contains different items. It would actually allow you to organize your enchanted books or even any written books, like all the booking data for all of these pillagers. I mean, it's gonna take me forever to get through this, but alas. I better get started. That's it for this idea. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. Ah, yes, the infamous End City. That is also not the most infamous structure in Minecraft. I mean, if you're anything like me, then you most likely agree that the End Cities could use something more. They just need something, some sort of enhancement. Well, that is where the new block, the Dismantler, comes in. This is a really cool block that fits the lore of Enderman and also gives you a reason to visit the End City, apart from, of course, getting an elytra. Now, this would be in-game material, so I think it would be perfectly fine to introduce a Dismantler. This would essentially be a decrafting block. Now, this is kind of a bad example, but if we go ahead and open this up, you can see that essentially, if we put in a block, it would decraft it. Now, obviously, you can already do that with blocks of ore, but imagine being able to do that for every other block in Minecraft. Now, this is something a lot of people have wanted for a very long time, and I can understand why it's not already in the game, but seeing as this would be in-game material, I think it would definitely be beneficial and give players all the more reason to defeat the Ender Dragon. So let me know what you think. I think that would be awesome. The block could probably be improved a little bit. I love it though. I made it myself. I did a good job. And as you can see, the end banner logo is on the top, which is pretty cool. But again, let me know what you think of this down in the comments below. All right, my friends. Next up, we've got an idea that, well, you know, honestly, I don't really know. I don't really know how to describe this next idea other than the fact that I want it. I want this in Minecraft so bad. This is the idea of a chest pet. Now, hear me out before you go. A fun pet that allows you to pick up your items on death and also follows you around. Now, I know you might be having a hard time imagining what this might look like. Oh man, Energy has really outdone himself with this one. But the thing is it actually will follow you around, or at least it should. It's a little stubborn at the moment. Let's try and get this going here. Come on. You could follow me now, chest pet. There he goes. Chest pet is now mobile. But I imagine that this would be a pet that follows you around and gives you additional storage when you need it. I mean, why have a backpack when you could have a chest pet? Look, he's in the corner there. This is a selfie with my chest pet. And then the best part is when you die, it would collect your items and wait for you, which I think would be awesome. It's like your own little droid, man. I love it. I think this is probably my favorite idea that we've had on this channel thus far. The chest pet, everybody. Oh my goodness. Next up, we are once again in the workshop. And today, we are checking out the pyrotechnic table. All right. Which one of you took the item? Was it you, Phil? It's always you. There. Okay, there it is. All right. This is the pyrotechnic table, which as you can see, has absolutely no function. Yeah, I'm not that great, but you can imagine that essentially this would be a crafting station that allows you to easily create using very easy recipes, fireworks, and all sorts of other explosives. This would essentially do to fireworks what the loom did to banners. I definitely think it's time for something like this in Minecraft because after all, I don't think really anybody crafts fireworks. It's just a little too difficult. And to be able to get firework prints, for example, would be amazing, especially consider some of the fireworks require diamonds to create over and over again. So this would just make it a little bit better and overall improve the firework system. Plus, maybe it could give us a way to easily get TNT. Once you've crafted one, perhaps it could give you just a little bit more TNT than the normal recipe. But of course, let me know what you think. And also, let me know what you think a good crafting recipe would be for this. What's that you say? You would like two ideas in one? Well, you've got it, my friend. This is the idea for a new tool and weapon known as the scythe. Now, this would be a weapon that would be similar to the trident. I've got a really cool idea for how this could work. But first, let's check out both of these ideas in one. Obviously, you can see we've got the new weapon, which of course would be the scythe, but it's also a tool, and tools need enchantments, and that would of course be autoplant. But before we talk about that, let me explain why this would be useful. Have you ever been in a scenario where you've got a bunch of grass around, or even better, you've got a bunch of crops around? The scythe would allow you to do what the sword does for mobs, but for blocks. So you could easily slice through a whole crowd of blocks about 3 blocks away from you and perhaps a full 180 degree in front of you and easily be able to collect all of them. I think that would be amazing. The auto plant enchantment would allow you to do that and easily automatically plant seeds down once you've done that, which I think we could all agree would be fantastic. Now, as far as how you would get this item, there are 2 ways it could be done. Number one, you could get it as a top tier trade from the farmer. But I think the better solution would be if you check out my most recent video, I introduced a Wraith mob. I would love it if that was a Reaper and this weapon was dropped from that Reaper. That would be awesome. But of course, let me know what you think of the site down in the comments below. Next up, we have an idea that I honestly think I can speak for everybody by saying it's something we need. And that is upgrades to really anything in Minecraft. There isn't anything that can genuinely be upgraded apart from tools and weapons on the progressional path. But this is an idea for an upgrade of an actual mechanic. That being saddles. Imagine being able to upgrade your horse by simply feeding it and taking good care of it, and eventually over time being able to support 2 saddles. And once you've done that, you can easily transport villagers and other mobs using that double saddle. That, I think, again, is something I really don't have to explain. I think everybody could agree that would be amazing. As far as how you would actually upgrade it, like I said, just take care of your horse, make sure it's fed and constantly lacking, you know, a lot of damage and all that kind of stuff, and eventually maybe it would upgrade. I think that is a system that would be amazing in various different areas of Minecraft. Let me know if you'd like a video detailing that just a little bit more. Well, for this next idea, we're back at the workshop, and Vil is hiding from Phil. Something tells me Phil is up to no good. Unfortunately, these next ideas don't really have an in-game example, but I still wanted to bring them to light because honestly, I think they would be an amazing addition to Minecraft. So that being said, let's check this out. As you can see, we just finished the double saddle, so we've got five other ideas, and I'm gonna run through these really quickly. Number 9, portable crafting. Imagine for completing all of your advancements, you actually got an award, an upgrade to your survival inventory, perhaps adding more slots and also expanding your crafting grid so that instead of it only being a 2x2 grid, you actually get a 3x3 grid. I think we can all agree that would be useful. And honestly, advancements don't really have any reward apart from XP, but an XP grinder would render that null and void. So having upgrades for completing advancements would be amazing. And of course, next up, you can see that we've got auto casting. Now imagine being able to put a fishing rod in a dispenser and actually have it cast out and reel back in whenever it detects a fish. That combined with some hoppers would be amazing. And even if this was its own redstone block, I would love to see this in the game, especially considering they fixed automatic fishing. Now the next one, of course, is re-dyeing blocks. Now I think we've all been there where we've accidentally dyed a block the wrong color. This would allow you to essentially re-dye a block back to white, which would then allow you to re-dye it to any color you'd like. Something I think we could all agree would be amazing. And then, of course, we've got the campfire fix. This would be a system that makes the campfire even more useful. If we head over here, you could see that I've used the campfire as a decoration because, well, truthfully, that's about all it's good for. But what if we fix that? Imagine that the campfire actually deters mobs. They don't like to go too close because it scares them. That would be awesome. But what if you could also get a splash potion and throw it on there? That way, any surrounding players would get the benefits. I know what you're thinking, that is a good idea. And last, but certainly not least, an idea from Phil himself. Now, I think a lot of people want dirt and sand slabs. The developers, however, have actively deterred against it. They do not want that in the game. They feel like it does not make sense. So, long story short, let's give them layers instead. Imagine being able to do this with sand and dirt. Now, as far as how you would get them, I don't imagine they would spawn naturally in Minecraft, but perhaps there could be a block to crush them down or even cut them up into smaller layers. This would be awesome, and as a builder, I would absolutely love to see this in the game. And with that, my friends, brings us the end of the list. I apologize for not having a good example of those last five, but as you could see, they are all very, very nice ideas. There are very many ways to improve the way of life in Minecraft, but one way that you can help this process along is by leaving your feedback on the feedback website for Minecraft, which I will go ahead and pin as a top comment on this video. You see Phil just staring at me? I really think we're probably in for something bad here with Phil here, but Phil has always been good to me, so, you know. But anyways, if you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a thumbs up and consider subscribing and turning on notifications so that you're alerted whenever I next upload a video. Also, let me know what you think of all of these ideas down below, and let me know what you would like to see next. That being said, my name has been System Z. You guys have been awesome, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.